Well, there are collectors all over the place, but most of them can fit their stuff in the closet or attic. But not Mike Watson. His sports memorabilia collection is so extensive, he had to convert the upstairs of his house into a museum. Mike gives us a peek at his collection and tells us the stories behind some of his favorites.
Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on third.
Are you the fellow that knows all the players?
I certainly.
Well, then who's on first?
Yes.
I mean the fellow's name.
Who?
The guy on first.
Who?
The first baseman.
Who?
The guy playing first.
Who is on first?
Now, what are you asking me for?
I started collecting baseball cards when I was 6 or 7 years old. From that, I moved into my father's collection, who was a big fan of the game, and I have some 1935 inserts into newspapers that I had autographed. The 1935 Tigers, it was their first World Series win, and that year, of course, Detroit and Michigan, the country, was in the Great Depression. It was a great thing for Michigan, for them to win, and Detroit became the city of champions. Memphis is a great sports town with a lot of history. The Memphis Redbirds are here, the great new stadium at AutoZone Park. It's a wonderful place to watch a game. Of course, we built the FedEx Forum here, where both the University of Memphis and Memphis Grizzlies play. It's a great place to watch a game. There's a lot of excitement. And we also have the River Kings in DeSoto County. And it's just a wonderful place to view sports. To get tickets to is easy, and it's just a lot of fun. We've got a lot of University of Memphis sports memorabilia. The Memphis Redbirds, of course, are the AAA affiliate of the St. Louis Cardinals. The biggest passion I have is baseball. I have over 800 signed baseballs. I have thousands of autographs on baseball cards, photos, on different types of memorabilia, hats. It's something that I started when I was younger with the 35 Tigers and have moved on. I have a lot of Yankee memorabilia. The New York Mets for their new stadium. I have the seats out of the old Shea Stadium. Over the years, I've collected about 2 million baseball cards. I have cards back from the 1910 era. I do have a card that is a Ty Cobb card. The first real collectible item was getting all the cards in the 1957 top set. Those cards are really great to look at. They're just wonderful cards and a lot of super good players in that era. And here I have a Joe DiMaggio single signed baseball. I have here the 1936 New York Yankees. There's 9 Hall of Famers with Lou Gehrig on a sweet spot. This is also Joe DiMaggio's rookie year with a 1933 Lou Gehrig card. This is a single signed Babe Ruth baseball signed in September of 1947 and a Mickey Mantle ball. The most unusual, maybe 2 items I have. The first is a ball that was used in a game from 1916 that I have. It's not signed by anyone who played in it, but it's going to be 100 years old soon, and it was used in a game. The other one that I have is a bat that I had signed by the entire mainland Chinese all-star team. They signed in English and also in their Chinese the characters. I had this bonus room with collectibles in it, and I also had our spare bedroom as an office with boxes of things and photos up on the wall, and it was kind of like walking through a minefield. You just didn't know where to step. And I came upstairs and designed the attic that I wanted to turn into a sports room. I think it's important to show things if you have them. I just like showing it. To stick it in a drawer just isn't any fun, so I like displaying it. Joe B. Scott is an old Negro Leagues player for the Memphis Red Sox. He was a pretty good ball player, And I met him at AutoZone Park. I've talked to him several times, and I want him to come and visit. I have a lot of items in my collection. If I could keep 5 items out of my collection, it would be the 57 Topps card complete set. The Babe Ruth baseball would certainly be the second one. Third would be the 1936 Yankees ball that I have, and that is Joe DiMaggio's rookie year, and Lou Gehrig has signed that on the sweet spot. There's 9 Hall of Famers on that ball, so that's a good one to keep. And then my set of 1935 Tigers signed, I think that would be a good one. The last one I'd probably keep would be the glove my mother bought me for my 9th birthday. It's a Wilson Jimmy Pearsall model, and she bought it at J.L. Hudson's in downtown Detroit. She paid $5 and got a 20% discount because she worked there. So it's a $4 glove, but I've had it over 50 years.